This video shows you how to use the scatter plugin with Redshift. So let's start by creating the scatter. We'll go to the create tab and drag out the scatter icon. Now from there, let's go to modify and we will pick the, first of all, let's just move this over. Let's pick the mesh. Let's pick the mesh that we're going to scatter onto first. So that's now set. We're going to use that mesh. Now let's pick the three teapots that I have placed down here. Let's bring that object count down from 10,000 to something a bit more sensible, say 1,000. And let's have a look at that now. So we've got a whole bunch of teapots in the scene. You can see that up to there. Let's change the distribution map to be full. So the whole object mesh is covered. Now let's fire up Redshift. It's worth pointing out at this stage that SiNi only supports standard rendering. At the moment I'm using progressive. We're not supporting IPR just yet, but we will in the near future. Now if I just keep that on screen there, let's now adjust the random transformation on these objects. Maybe we want to adjust the rotation to a full 360, and let's drop the scale down to 80 to 120 and turn on collision because we don't want everything overlapping. So now let's fire that up and have a look at the render again. You can see now we've got some variation in scale and all the objects are rotated in different directions. Okay, now you can update all and reseed, and that will just regenerate all the cyclone objects. That's up to you. If you don't like the look of it, you're wanting to actually just change it a bit. And then what we're going to do next is let's just have a look at the materials. So we've got a red, we've got a green, and we've got a blue. Now they're all using the preset silver material, which works great. We're not going to go into the shaders in Redshift. You can go to the Maxon website or Redshift for that. Now, I want to point out that the custom material is the only one that our color correction supports. So let's delete these objects. And now let's add the fourth teapot. Now that has the custom, just a basic custom material on it. So if we come over here to the right, let's go down to the color and texture variation. So let's have a look at that before I apply it. So you can see it's all a very, very neutral beige color. Let's bring up the hue shift and let's bring up saturation. And then let's re-render that. You'll see that that's now gonna bring in a whole bunch of color variation to the image that was set to 12 before. Let's now change that. Let's bring that up to 20, see if we get any more variation. Not a lot, but you can see that's how you can use it. Now you can use this on materials. So you can specify a material, could be a car paint, could be someone's clothing, that then you can actually just add color variation to. That's a really quick way of actually adding more variation to your scene. So that's, again, just reminding you that is using just the custom. The specialized materials will not work with color variation. So finally, if you want to learn more about scatter, go to our help docs using the question mark in the plugin. From there, you'll be able to actually learn everything there is to know about scatter and in more detail. We've also got training videos there to watch as well. So hopefully this is of interest. And by the way, it is free scatter, so enjoy.